resident here. I come almost on a daily basis to volunteer, to give back what God had given to me freely when I came here. I had a problem. I went to treatment, and when I came out of treatment, my then wife, she no longer seemed that she wanted me in part of her life. So she asked me to leave, so I left, and I went to the hotel, and I had a car and everything. And I was working when I came out. And someone suggested that I call here. I called here, and they asked me to come in for an interview, and I came in for an interview. And I, you know, it's just one of these places that, it's not the first time I was homeless. You know, I grew up on the streets of D.C. You know, I smoked the crack. I've been in prison. I shacked the dope. I did everything wrong, you know. But by the grace of God, I'm still here. It's amazing. We went out to count people in the woods, and it was in the paper. You know, count the homeless people and stuff like that. It's a lot of things going on in America, you know, and not only in Virginia, but all over this country. You know, and people think that they can find the answer in substances. My 18-year-old son surprised me. I mean, he just graduated from Freedom, and already he's using drugs. He was in the ROTC, he had plans to go in the military, and it seems like Satan is trying to sift out young people like we. And he's caught up in that. And no matter how much I talk to him, or preach to him, or tell him that he must turn his life over to God, he chooses not to. So I know what kept me all of these years, because I used to OD on drugs all the time in Washington. I sold drugs. You know, I was a mess. I used to always say I was going to die on 14th Street. That was back when 14th Street was the drug quarter. And it's only by the grace of God that he kept me and let me live thus far. And I am so grateful. I know it wasn't all of my doing, because I should, if it was left up to me, I'd be in the ground. But he kept his hand on me. God has kept his hand on me. And I'm so glad that people come up here and bringing the idea and the theology about Christ can save us. Yeah. That's what's missing. But that's my personal feelings. I mean, the Congress can't help it. The Republicans, the Democrats, they can help. Christ can help. Yeah. We've got to stop depending on man and depend on Almighty God. Yes. That is what's missing in the schools, yes, and in some of the churches, yes, even some of the churches. Yes. You know, but you go there and the only thing but that they want is it's money. I'm not saying but that we shouldn't tithe, but it's not about money. You know, because God said that if the birds never need anything, do you think that we was created in his image that we would need something? And when we think but that we don't have everything but that we should, God has always got our back. I think that God is sending you people here from Africa to show us, to show the people in America how we should live and be true to Almighty God.
Amen.
Health-wise, I do.
I talk to you.
Yeah. And I met this beautiful woman.
Yeah. People are coming together, you know, feeding out a good name of the Lord, you know, being servants.
Amen.
Thank you. God.
We thank you for giving us this privilege to be a blessing to us.
That's it.
But that's it.
Good. I'm making a difference on their life. So I hope God will make a difference on my life.
Amen.
going on for other people. That's what our God, our Lord, Jesus has made for. That when He gave to us, He also gave to us. So we're doing this and we are all so happy. We're having fun with them, taking pictures with them. Everything is going on well. We wish we can do it every month. We wish that. In Jesus' name, we are welcome.
It's a blessing.
How do you feel about feeding the homeless?
We feel blessed.
We feel blessed.
Feeding the homeless because we know we're going to be blessed.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
I'm happy to be here. I'm blessed. I'm happy to feed them because it's so amazing to be here to feed your other people. You know, but the word says what? If you don't do it for your brother, then which is you did not do it for me. So I'm so obliged to do this. I'm happy. Amen.
Thank you. Amen.
I pray that the Spirit of God will from this day make you an angel.
Amen.
That God will channel His blessings through your life.
Yes.
That everybody who comes to this shelter, God will bless them.
Amen.
That we are here to make a difference, and we bless that God, that God has already made a lot of difference in our lives already. We're going to bless them, we're going to feed them. Please talk to them, give somebody a hug, maybe one smile you could give to somebody who turns somebody's life around. You gotta shake somebody's hands. Let's bless them as much as we can. The rest of the blessings is God that will give it unto us.